Students, what's the question? Next question. The next question what we observe over here is what? What is Doppler effect? Okay. What is Doppler effect? Okay. So let me explain the thing via taking what example. So if I take the example of one observer is there, which is called listener also, and one motor car. Okay. Now there are two possibilities. Either motor car is moving towards the observer or it is moving away from the observer. Okay. Let it be. But my first question to Miss Riya Ajay. Riya, will you tell me if car is moving towards observer by making some sound, okay, horning. So observer will feel what? There is an increase in intensity of sound or decreasing intensity of sound when it is moving towards. Sorry, Riya.
Decreasing
or increasing?
Decreasing.
Why decreasing? Suppose motor car is making a sound, horning, and what it is moving towards.
Moving towards, then it is increasing.
Yes. So means what? Sound has fixed frequency, say, and not. And not is what we will say is a natural frequency or intensity frequency of what? That sound. Okay. That is a frequency of what? Sound. Which will be a fixed frequency. Okay. Which will be what? Fixed frequency. This is what frequency of sound. But because car is moving towards the observer, there is a change in frequency. Matlab, this observer feels it is there is a change in frequency. That frequency change in frequency is called apparent frequency. Okay, N dash, apparent frequency. Okay. So what Doppler effect states that apparent frequency is always be N naught, that is what actual frequency of the sound, multiply by, here I will say V, Vs, V, VO, V, Vs, Vs we will say here, we will say listener I will say, and here what source, okay, listener will come in the numerator and S, that is what velocity of sound. So what is VL? VL is the velocity of listener. Velocity of listener. Matlab either observer is, suppose I will say, I will change the question. I will say this observer is also moving towards. Matlab both are moving towards each other. So definitely there is an increment in what? Intensity of sound, frequency of that sound. That what is the change? So if it is moving towards, no, then you have to remember, but let me say first, what is VL? VL is the velocity of listener, because this observer is also moving, no, with the velocity VL, and this is source of sound. This is what? Source of sound, which is also moving towards, okay, source of sound is represented by VS. So this is what VS is, a velocity of source, velocity of source. Okay, and what is V? V is the actual velocity of sound. V is the velocity of sound. So students, what I need to find out apparent frequency of that sound, we need fixed frequency of the sound, we need velocity of the sound. VL is the velocity of what? Listener. Listener is what? Moving towards. And second one is what? Vs, velocity of velocity of source. Okay, that is also moving towards. When it is moving towards, no, the students, you have to remember the formula. There is a derivation also there, a proof, but that is out of syllabus, that is omitted. So only we have to remember the formula. If it is moving towards, no, the students, you always remember plus will come in the numerator and minus will come in the denominator. Okay, there is a proof also, but that proof is omitted. Okay, if we have time in college, when college will start, no, that time I will prove it. But this year, this proof is what? Emitted or only omitted. Okay. Okay. So this is of apparent frequency when it is moving towards. And when it is moving away. Now question from the students is what? Sir, suppose sir, it is moving away. Na? Yahan pe ja raha hai, source of this sound is also moving away. When it is moving away, The formula, remember the formula, n dash is given by same formula v v l v v l upon v v s. Only plus, only minus will come in the numerator and plus will come in the denominator. Okay, so this is what formula to find out what apparent frequency when either source is moving towards or observer is moving towards or both are moving away from the each other. Okay, so this is what apparent change in frequency, and such phenomenon is called Doppler effect. So there is apparent change in frequency of sound due to relative motion between what source and listener. What is Doppler effect? Doppler effect is the apparent change in the frequency, okay, of what sound due to what? Due to relative motion between source and listener. Relative motion means what? Either they are moving towards or they are moving away. Such phenomenon is called Doppler effect. Okay. So, hope so everyone understood. Okay. So, let me write down the next point. So, you have to write some points in the exam. So, let me complete the second point. So, wave Doppler effect is a wave phenomenon. The second point you have to write down. First, you have to first point an explanation. Then you have to say Doppler effect is wave phenomenon. But it is related with the sound wave or some wave. Right? Wave phenomenon. Then the changes in the frequency can be studied under three different conditions. The three different conditions means what? What is the three conditions? Three conditions are first maybe we will say when listener and the listener is stationary and source is moving. Matlab what? Listener is stationary. Listener is stationary means what? VL is zero and source is what? Moving. Okay, this is the first condition. Second, listener is moving matlab having some velocity and source is what? Stationary. Okay, stationary means what? Zero. Okay, stationary means what? That is not moving. Okay, this is the second condition. And third condition is what? When both are moving. Okay, VL is also moving and VS is also moving. So what are the three conditions for Doppler effect? Listener is stationary. Stationary means what? Its velocity is zero. And source is moving. Matlab observer is standing over here and source is moving. Either way, moving away or moving towards. That are its sub conditions. But what is the basic condition? Observer is stationary. Source is moving. Next, source is stationary. Observer is moving. Moving towards or moving away. And second condition is what? Both are moving towards each other or both are moving away from each other. And the fourth condition, some students are asking, sir, if both are stationary, then so there is no change in frequency. If I am standing here and car is also honing over there only, that car is neither moving towards me nor away from me. So what will happen? Whatever sound will come, there is no change in frequency, no change in what? Some intensity of sound. It remains same. So there is no Doppler effect. For Doppler effect, either one of the two things should moving. Okay, either one of the, either listener moving towards or away, source is moving towards away, or both moving towards and away. Everyone understood? Say yes or no. Hope so everyone understood this concept.